없네. 세샷. 2.5 years of training here at Sunny's Academy, I've come to understand not only the importance of these tenets, but I've realized the impact they have had on my life from the very beginning. As I look back on my journey, I can attribute much of my success to the following of these principles. It was my courtesy to others and the integrity they saw in me that created lifetime friendships and partnerships. It was my perseverance that got me to college, which gave me the opportunity to pursue my dreams. It has been my battles with self-control and the development of it that have helped define my character. Being able to breathe, take a step back, and reevaluate a situation is a handy tool that has come with age. Ultimately, it has been the indomitable spirit that propelled me through many of my challenges. I attribute learning most of these principles early on from my mother, who lived a much harsher life than I could ever imagine. Against all odds, she succeeded in raising 6 children who went on to become responsible adults. 2 of them with their own families, and 4 of them who made it to college. A PhD engineer, a nurse practitioner, a self-employed artist, and one that's still in Long Beach State. Taekwondo has connected these principles that have been around me all my life and honed them into tenets. It's been a wild ride so far, and I would like to share with you how my pursuit for my dream of becoming an artist brought me here. When I was a young kid, about the age of some of you lower ranks, I decided to become an artist. I made a decision to become an artist. I had always loved to draw, and people were very encouraging of my talents. So from grade school through high school, I sketched everywhere I could, all over my school books, journals, whenever inspiration struck. When I signed up for college, I found out that I had to declare a career path. Without much hesitation, I enrolled in the studio arts major. Luckily, my family was pretty cool with that decision. I think that they were just happy to have one of us kids reach college, as both of my older brothers had dropped out of high school. The only question I got from my mom was, how are you gonna make a living out of that? To which I replied, I don't know yet, but I'll figure it out. I knew the road would be long and that nothing was guaranteed, but I had faith that with hard work, determination, and perseverance, all my efforts would come to fruition. After receiving my AA from Orange Coast College in Southern California, I decided to continue to pursue that dream, and that path led me directly to Humboldt State University. The reason I decided on Humboldt was because HSU is still the only school in the country that has a metals casting program for undergraduates. I came here for sculpture. After 3 years of hard work and dedication, I graduated in 2007 at the top of my class and earned various accolades for my proficiency in a wide variety of artistic mediums as well as for my group organizational skills. Then came time for the truth. How to make a living after 2 years of not working and accumulating a hefty student debt. Luckily, I have found a few jobs straight out of college, thanks to my networking during my time at Sculpture Club president. Those 2 jobs kickstarted my ambition to become a self-employed small business owner, and in 2009, I filed with the county and made Vico Designs official. I am grateful to call myself a working artist privileged to work with many local businesses in the area, like Humboldt Brews, Muddy Waters Coffee, Tofu Shop, and many more. Which leads me to how I became a student here at Sunnys. In early 2012, I received an email through my website from a master, Corey Lewis of Sunnys Taekwondo Academy. He was inquiring about a potential mural project he had in mind that would help make his building pop so that people could easily identify the academy. Although I had never painted a mural before, I was a proficient oil painter, and I knew that I could take on the challenge and in the process become a better artist. I quickly accepted the job and was very excited because painting a mural was a goal that I had always dreamt of. Needless to say, the process went smoothly as planned, and it was a success for both myself and the academy. After the completion of the mural, I asked Master Lewis if he had any other design projects that he needed done for the academy. I also told him that I was very interested in joining and that perhaps we could work out a trade of sorts, to which he replied a very enthusiastic yes. Since then, we've been on a mission to improve the connection of the academy with its students and to facilitate an easier learning experience by providing a robust website and social media presence. At the same time, I have had the opportunity to develop a part of myself that I've only dreamt about for most of my life. You see, going back to when I was young, I saw the movie Karate Kid. Like many other kids who watched that movie, it sparked a very real interest in the martial arts. But unfortunately, my mother, being a single mom, did not have the resources or time to enroll me in such activity. Then when I got older, I figured I had grown too old to consider going into a dojo and trying to enroll. But ultimately, it was my perseverance through my belief in becoming a visual artist that the martial arts finally became a reality in my life. Had I not persevered and showed an indomitable spirit through my pursuit of the arts, I would perhaps have never set a step in the dojo. And now as I get ready to test for my first degree and prepare to move to Southern California, I can see that this journey has just begun. Taekwondo has become my door into the martial arts, and it has opened my eyes to the potential of my physical and mental capabilities. Taekwondo has become family and community. Taekwondo has become discipline and success. Taekwondo has become health and love. Taekwondo has become a way of life. And yes.
Hey, hey, hey. Hernandez.